Welcome to Office Mechanics. Coming up on today's show, we're going to take a look at how you can extend Office 365 with new popular SaaS applications. We'll also take a look at how you can connect to Office 365 services, so stay tuned. I'm joined by Chris Johnson. Welcome.
Thanks very much. Thanks for having me on the show.
So what's changed? What's new with the new developer model with Office?
So Office is all about developers being able to extend and connect to Office 365. And so by that we mean extend the Office applications to add new capabilities, new functionality, and things like that. And then when we talk about connecting to Office 365, we mean connecting from things like web applications, mobile phone applications, or other line of business systems to get access to all the rich data in Office 365.
We've been making a ton of momentum lately in terms of having a lot of the most frequently used SaaS application builders out there integrate with Office, right?
Absolutely, and we're going to see a whole lot of these today. We're going to walk through some examples of some great work that our partner organizations have been working on.
So let's take a look at some of the examples that we have that we've talked about this week and last week. Because this is really exciting stuff. Some of the most major apps that people are thinking about today using in business as well as in their private lives, Salesforce.com, SAP, Uber, really cool in terms of extending the Office experience. Why don't we stop talking to our slide here and actually show a couple of demonstrations of these really great SaaS applications that are integrating with Office 365.
Okay, so where we're going to start first is on my PC. So first up, I'm going to show you an example from SAP that we're working on. Now, let's start in Excel here. So this is Excel, the client on the desktop, right? So the Excel most people are used to seeing. Down the right-hand side, you can see the SAP integration add-in. Now, this is working with SAP data on-premises using the SAP gateway for Microsoft. So what I can do here is come into Excel, connect to data in SAP, and manipulate it and work with it in the application I like to work with data and report on it and pivot on it and so forth. But these don't just work in the Excel applications on the desktop, right?
Right, because SAP, in this case, they want to be able to make sure that they're there pervasively across all the different Excel experiences. So a lot of people are using Excel online, for example, in order to be able to modify, edit spreadsheets. We have that integration as well, right?
Exactly, right? So if I flip over to that same spreadsheet in Excel online, you see the add-in down the right-hand side, just the same as you would on the desktop. And the way this is enabled is our new add-in framework is based on web technologies. So no longer the old COM add-ins of old. These are built using HTML and JavaScript, which means we can run them in the browser when you're in Excel online as well.
But even going beyond just what we can do on the PC or in a browser, which, by the way, isn't necessarily on a PC, it could be on another device type, we also have native apps for Office running on other platforms, in this case iOS, and we also have the ability to actually have that SAP app run in Excel coming very soon, right?
That's right. So last week at Build, we announced new capabilities for add-ins to run in Office for iPad. So the first application that's shipping with is Excel. So people will see an update for Excel coming soon, which will enable this add-in. So if we flip to our iPad here, so this is just a blank spreadsheet, but I can come into the Insert tab and say add-ins, I want to add the SAP add-in right in line on the right-hand side here. I can come down to my product data, I can click on that, I want to bring it into my Excel spreadsheet and manipulate it and report on it. I click Connect. You'll see that data flow right into the Excel spreadsheet up here on the iPad. Now I can come along and edit this data. Often people want to work with the data in Excel and report on it and so forth. So if I come in here and change some data, let's change this from 3.5 to say 200. It's going to be really expensive milk. And if I come in here, I can also do, before I save it back up to the server, I might want to see what's changed. I just want to be sure my edits are okay. So I can come in here and click Compare and Save. And I'll get a little report in the add-in that says, row number 3, I've changed from 3.5, which is the data in SAP, to now 200 in Excel. So I can come in here and tap which one I'd like to stick with, and then save it up to SAP when I'm done.
And that's really great. So we're seeing a lot of great extensibility. The thing that is really exciting about these new apps, these new add-ins, is the fact that it is actually cross-platform now. Because we're using effectively iframes in order to have that integration work, It means that we're not using that old, the older add-in model that we had, for example, in Office on the desktop. This is why we've moved on to a new model where we can actually work in the desktop, work in the browser, work on the iPad, but beyond just data management and really doing what we're doing here in Excel, our daily lives, looking on things like our calendar, our mail, we've also got a lot of exciting updates there as well, right?
Absolutely. Let's flip back to the PC here and take a look at Outlook. And I'll show you a couple of examples of applications we've been working on with some great partners around those scenarios. So the first one that's actually live in the Office store today is Salesforce.
Okay.
So when you're working with mail, often in Outlook, right, you want to look up contacts from Salesforce, potentially account information from Salesforce, as well as things like opportunities. So if I come in here to a mail from myself in this case, and open the Salesforce app up, I can get access to this rich data from Salesforce right in line and in context in Outlook. So it looks up my details from Salesforce. I can see the contact information. I can see account information. It's beautiful and touch-friendly. So it works great on a Surface without a keyboard, for example. I can see my opportunities that I'm working on and any cases associated with it. So it works nice and in line and in context with my mail. And it means I don't have to switch between applications to look this data up or work with other applications.
Really great. Even beyond that, though, there's some really great apps and add-ins out there that really help your email experience. Things like Boomerang as well, right?
Exactly, right? So Boomerang is a really popular service that helps you work with email. Often, I'll send somebody an email to say, hey, I need some information about something, or please go and do this. Mm-hmm. But then I have to put that as a task in some other system to remind me to follow up with that person.
Right.
So what Boomerang lets me do is when I'm composing an email, I can add the Boomerang add-in down the right-hand side here and simply tick this box that says, remind me in, and I can configure what the time period happens to be, whether it be 4 hours or a few days or a month, when to remind me. And what it will do is put this email back in my inbox when the time comes, and it prompts me and reminds me to go and follow up with that person.
That's really great. So that's going to help you, again, manage your communications and make sure you can get back to the things that you might have forgotten otherwise without it. But even beyond that, one of the apps I bet a lot of people are even using this week here in Chicago, the Uber app. We can do things with that as well, right?
Exactly. So Uber is a great car or ride-sharing service that get you places, right? And often with meetings, you have the meeting in your calendar, but you have to look at your calendar and then have a task reminder tell you to go order a car or something along those lines. We've been working with Uber to make an Uber add-in for Outlook that will mean that Uber will prompt you, say 15, 45 minutes before your meeting to order a car. So I can come into the Uber app here and I simply just set my phone number. In this case, let me just type in a number here and say set reminder. And then in the background, I can set the ride reminder time. So in this case, 45 minutes before my meeting, Uber on my phone is going to send a notification, and it's really simple to order a car. You just simply slide to ride. Now, the important part here is that it's not just the Uber application that most people are familiar with today, where you have to type in your destination. Because it's embedded in Outlook, we're able to take the meeting location from the appointment and Uber pre-populate that in their application. So they pull that through and you don't have to re-key things on the fly.
That's really cool. Exciting new APIs. But even beyond what we're seeing here on the business side with Outlook.com, we're also extending that as well, right?
That's right. So in the future, you'll see these add-ins quickly coming to Outlook.com for over 400 million users on our consumer mail service, mm-hmm. as well as in the commercial service in Office 365.
So beyond what we're showing here in terms of extending the Office experiences, we also have additional things that we can do to connect to the back-end services that are running Office 365. So why don't we take a look at a few things there, because I know there's a lot of new stuff, if you're not aware of the like app launcher, et cetera, that we can do. Not only that, but the APIs that we can call to get into the back-end services.
Yeah, absolutely. So although the examples I've shown you so far are all in the Office client applications, I just want to show you a quick example of what we're doing to extending the experience in Office 365 in the browser through the app launcher. So you're probably familiar with the app launcher in Office 365. It shows you all of the great first-party apps that are available, like Mail, Calendar, People, OneDrive, and so forth. But for developers, it's also they're also able to drop their applications on this app launcher. A good example of this would be maybe putting your intranet as a tile on the app launcher. It can also be used for third-party applications that you want to put in front of users in this way. So down on the bottom right, it's a little hard to see here, the My Apps button. And if you click on that, that'll take you through to a page where you can see all of the applications you have access to. We pull this information from Active Directory, or Azure Active Directory, I should say, and it'll show you not only the first-party applications you're allowed to get access to, but third-party ones that you might have registered for as well. So at the top of the page, you can see Mail, Calendar, People, and so forth. But at the bottom, you can see Do, DocuSign, and Smartsheet. Mm-hmm. And these are partners that have added Azure Active Directory authentication, which means that the, people can go and log in with their Office 365 credentials to those applications.
And you can even pin them right to that initial start experience as well, right?
Exactly, right? So we come in, I'll pick Do here and say Pin to App Launcher. And when that's done, I can get quick access right off the App Launcher here. So this is done using Azure Active Directory authentication. We're able to smartly pull those in. But there's more that comes with this as well. Once a partner or once a developer has built this off, into their application, we can do smart things like single sign-on. So once they're in Office 365, they tap this button, they'll get seamless authentication right across into the partner application, or maybe some other line of business system that they've built.
So it's like they're right integrated directly into the Office 365 portal and console. The other thing is it also integrates with the MyApp side on the Azure portal as well. So very great integration across that. But I know even beyond that, you can also build your own custom apps that draw into those Office 365 APIs and services as well, right?
Exactly. Let's use Do as an example here. Okay. So if I tap the Do button, it's going to launch a new tab and log me into Do. Now, for those of you who don't know Do, do.com is their site. They're a great partner that builds on the meeting experience. They help you arrange agendas and tasks and outcomes from meetings. You can share it with others outside of your organization as well, so it helps make the meeting experience much nicer. But what do on the back end is use our calendar API to call into Office 365 and pull a list of meetings from your Exchange calendar. So here in Do on Thursday the 7th, I can see I've got a couple of meetings set up. I've got the Ignite studio session that we're doing here today. We've got the attendee party tonight. Okay. If I scroll down, I can see some other meetings that I've got set up in my calendar. You can also set up new meetings here, and they'll push back into the calendar as well. So it's a bi-directional sync. So what they're doing is they're using your Office 365 authentication token that you've granted this app access to. In this case, I've just said, please just get access just to my calendar. So they don't have access to everything in 365, just the things
that you've scoped.
Just the things that you've consented to.
Right.
And then they're using that calendar API on the back end to dive in there and grab this information. But this, you know, this goes beyond just calendars. We've got APIs for email, calendar, people, search, taxonomy, all sorts of different rich APIs you can call, as well as things like the Office Graph.
So really great stuff. We can not only extend Office, but we can also connect to the Office services, and you can use the tools and platforms that you want to use to develop these types of add-ins, these types of experiences that we're showing here today. But if I'm a developer, where do I go to get started? Sorry.
Yeah, the simplest thing that you can do is just go to dev.office.com. You can sign up for our developer program. We're giving everybody a free Office 365 developer subscription for a year. It's the best way to get started with Office 365 and get up and running.
Really good stuff. So dev.office.com. Also, any news as it breaks, we're going to have that on the Office blog and on Wednesdays on Office Mechanics. That's about all the time we have for today. Thank you for watching, and goodbye for now.